For almost 2 years, we've been working extremely hard to bring home these two Michaels. It is an absolute priority for the government. I won't be commenting on any of the recent reports.
The Prime Minister not revealing anything about reports that Huawei executive Meng Wanzhou might be close to reaching a deal that would set her free from Canadian custody. Many believe her case tied to the fate of two Canadians currently in Chinese custody, Michael Spavor and Michael Kovrig. The Wall Street Journal and Reuters both saying Huawei executive Meng Wanzhou's lawyers are in talks with American officials that could see her freed under a deferred prosecution agreement, an admittance of guilt in exchange for freedom. But Meng would have to flip-flop, always maintaining her innocence. It's been 2 years this week since Canadian authorities at Vancouver's International Airport detained Meng on an extradition treaty with the United States, accused of breaking sanctions against Iran. Shortly after, China detaining Canadians Michael Spavor and Michael Kovrig on spy charges.
It might have been a word from Beijing to Huawei saying, look, this business is tarnishing the image of China too much. It's time to try to seek a compromise.
News of a possible deal for Meng is giving some hope for the return of the two Michaels.
Pretty sure that Ambassador Barton and his team in Beijing is in discussion with Chinese officials to try to discuss possible arrangements. I think that it might be possible for China to agree to such a deal because the trial of Michael Kovrig and Michael Spavor has not yet started.
But Chinese officials denying a link between the cases, despite timelines and rhetoric. Canada now relying on support from the Americans, but some believe that if they omit the two Michaels from their plan, it would leave Canada with pie on its face.
Mr. Trump and Mr. Pompeo, Vice President Pence have all come to Canada and said, no, we've got your back on this one. You know, we have the Michaels' interests at heart. So if they're negotiating some kind of deal and renege on that, then it will leave the Trudeau government holding the bag, and you can be sure that Canada-U.S. relations will also take a dive.
In the meantime, Meng remains in her Vancouver mansion, where she is forced to wear an ankle bracelet, while the two Michaels sit in a Chinese prison, cut off from consular visits. Holden not expecting the Michaels to be freed anytime soon.
Unfortunately, because the Chinese do not want the signal or to admit that the cases are linked, there would be, at a minimum, in my view, a delay of weeks or months before the Michaels would be held. But the prospects of them being released and sent back to Canada improve greatly.
In Ottawa, Nigel Newlove, City News.